My name is Alegra Woodard, and I'm a cervical cancer survivor. 1999, I get a call from my service provider, my medical service provider, to let me know that the results of my biopsy were not good news. It was a long day. It was a long drive to the clinic. And she told me that I had stage one cervical cancer and I needed an operation immediately. She asked me if I was okay. And I said, yes, I'm fine. I didn't cry. I didn't say a word. I got in my car and I drove home. And on my way home, I cried all the way to the house. I got home, I parked, dried my tears, and decided to be strong for my family. I was silent about how I felt, what happened to me for 14 years. I'm a 16-year cancer survivor, and it's only now that I can say those words. Silence is not an option for me anymore. Because I realized that with my silence, not only did I hurt myself, I hurt those that were trying to help me, but also I kept silent and I did not help other women, other families, other caregivers in their battle against cervical cancer, and for that effect, any other cancer. So, as I said, silence is no longer an option for me. I am a cervical cancer survivor. What I did say about my name is that my middle name is Esperanza, which means hope. And what I want every single person to know, and especially what I will tell myself, is that there is hope. That it's not the end of the road. That you are stronger than what you think you are. That you survive for a reason, and that you have a purpose. And it's just a matter of time when that will be revealed to you. My most powerful moment happened last year when I attended Survivor School in San Diego. I was sitting just talking about survivorship with other women, and my daughter, which is 28 today, was one of those women in that circle. And when she was asked, what's your story? She said, I'm not a survivor. Someone else told her, yes, you are. You survived cervical cancer with your mother. So the most powerful moment happened last year, in which my daughter recognized that she also had a struggle and she also had a battle, but that we all were able to survive. And we are now the voice of cervical cancer and able to talk and be helpful to other women and families. So I really didn't know what to expect when I got the invitation for Raw Beauty. I did some research online. I knew that it had to do with a calendar. But this day is an amazing day. It's a day in which you share with other survivors. You learn from their stories. And the most important thing is that you, when you think that you've had it rough, you realize that other people have struggled and survived and conquered a lot more. It's a support group, it's a way of coming together, fellowship with beautiful people, not only women, men, adults, children. It is just so amazing. I am so blessed that I was able to participate this year. And I just know that this is just the beginning of a long lasting relationship in which I will be able to donate of my time, energies, and efforts. And also that Raw Beauty will be able to promote and be able to assist me in my goals for cervical cancer. My name is Alegra Esperanza Woodard, and I am RB Proud.
Sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open.
Purchase your calendars today and view full testimonies online at www.rawbeauty.org. Thank you for your support.